Well, the bar is officially open, and I like your style, Sarah. This is so much fun. We're so glad to have you back, first of all.
Yeah, thanks for having me back.
Your projects are always just, like, jaw-dropping to me.
Yay.
What did this used to be in a former life?
In a former life, this was a Graco diaper-changing table.
Y'all, it was a diaper-changing table.
That's right, you guys. So the reason I turned this into a bar cart, first of all, the height, right? Because you know bar carts are so tiny.
They are.
I mean, I'm not a tiny person, but then I also like to wear heels.
Yeah.
You want to be able to like make a drink and not be leaning down into it. So they already come on wheels. They're super tall. You've got a ton of shelves. And then why not upcycle it into something else, right?
I love it. So what color was it and what'd you do paint-wise, first of all?
Well, I actually found this one on Craigslist. I didn't have one of these for my kids. I just did the,
on the
couch thing. But I got this for like $20 on Craigslist.
Perfect.
It was just plain wood.
Mm-hmm.
Took all of the little straps off and all the little hardware, anything that said Graco, gave it a good sand.
Mm-hmm.
The first time I did it, I painted it metallic gold.
Mm-hmm.
And then I actually, for this show, I gave it a new life with, because you can always change it up again with this carbon mist color. So you can change it, you know, it doesn't have to stay the paint color you choose the first time. You could even go like hot pink with like flamingo paper on it or something
so cute
for girls.
Okay, speaking of the paper, when I walked in and at first glance across the studio, I was like, wow, she got that heavy marble cart in here. And it's actually not marble, it's faux.
It is,
right?
It's faux. And I wish I could show it a little bit here. I guess I could peel up a corner. It is this faux marble contact paper,
that's,
I think,
so awesome.
And it's from Walmart. It's really inexpensive. And I saw it in there and I was like, oh, that's cool. And you can't even tell, like up close, like you really can't tell.
No, it's fantastic.
And it's beveled. So, you know, your glassware and things stay on it. Nothing's falling over. So that's really nice. And you just kind of cut it to fit. Doesn't have to be perfect. Like in the back, you can see it's a little off, but who sees that? You know?
No, not at all.
So yeah, and it works really well. And then also you can put, I put a little towel over the side there. So you've got your little,
Very official. So, now let's talk about how you accessorized it.
Yes.
I love how you make it look like $1 million, but you really keep it on a budget that's accessible to most of us.
Absolutely.
I love that.
Well, first of all, you can shop your own house.
That's
your friend's garage or your mother-in-law's, wherever. But mirrors are a great thing to add to any table, I think, but definitely to a bar cart because it adds some depth. And then this was all of these things on the bar cart, minus the alcohol, was less than $25.
Yes.
Purchased secondhand, garage sales, thrift stores.
Yeah.
Cake stand's always a great thing.
Yes.
This is an old candy dish. Put your lemons and limes
so
in
cute.
It. You can find some great stemware at Goodwill. And buy different colors. Have fun with it. You know, it doesn't have to be all the same matchy-matchy. Make it festive and fun.
That's true. If you found three of one and three of another, get them, mix them up. You've got a set of six, and it
Absolutely.
Looks kind of intentional.
Yeah, and it's fun. I even found that wine decanter down there.
What else? Yeah,
There's a decanter down here, and the martini glasses I found. Also, I found a shaker, which I forgot today, but I actually found a shaker. Wine key I found.
If you're
this was at a garage sale, 50 cents.
Perfect.
Right? Little bit of mercury glass. It's always good to add a candle to your bar cart. Got this at Goodwill. So, you know, hey, you can get... If you already have one of a changing table, rework it with some spray paint. I like to do, I brought the can I use for this.
Yeah,
I like to use the primer and the paint in one.
Yeah,
and make it shiny. Yeah, let it be shiny. Have some fun with it. I think it looks a little more bougie.
Well, and I love too, like you were saying, the scale and the height. It's more like a piece of furniture. So you're going to have this against a wall. It's really going to take up some space and look intentional, not like a mini bar cart.
No, not tiny in the corner. Absolutely. And the great thing about this too, I can't remember if I mentioned it before, it's on wheels.
Yes.
So most bar carts come on wheels, or not bar carts, but most diaper changing tables come on wheels too. And if it doesn't, you could always add some.
Yeah.
That's awesome because then you're just wheeling it from the nursery right into the kitchen, right? Because you need those beverages.
Move the baby to the high chair. Put the tequila down.
Yep.
We're in business.
And you're set. You're good to go. I know.
So how can we follow you and see more of your awesome projects? Because you are just always doing the cutest stuff.
Some interesting things, I know, I'm telling you. Instagram is a good spot for me. I'm at Redo Kids, REDUXKIDZ, or Secondhand Style with Sarah T is also on Instagram. It's all under one page.
Yeah.
So you can see all my projects and what I'm doing. I'm doing some things on my house right now, some upcycling reclaim projects and renovations, and always working on fashions, refashions, things for kids, doing some back to school things to help get prepped for kids, and definitely bar carts for mom and dad.
Yeah.
Or grandma or aunt or whoever. So yeah, that's where you can find me.
We have a little more time on our hands these days. We want to do projects like this. What are some maybe top three suggestions of places people can go and find things on a budget and then bring them home and rework them?
First things first is your kid's nursery or your garage. I just did a piece of a baby gate, took the piece off, repainted it, added some cool little hooks to it, hung it on the wall, and put books on it for the kids.
Okay.
So I would say just be resourceful with things that you already have.
And
then second of all, Goodwill. Mm-hmm. Goodwill is a great time to go right now. Everybody has just literally been cleaning out their entire house, right? I mean, everything is gone.
Yes.
So clothing, refashion, you find a skirt that you like, you can make it shorter. You can find a ton of these, ton of crutches, ton of walkers. I've done some upcycles with those you can find on my Instagram.
Yeah.
All for very inexpensive. So I would definitely suggest your own house, your mother-in-law's house, or the Goodwill.
Good stuff.
Yeah.
Brian, can we make you a drink?
Yes, you can.
Do you like beverage?
Yes,
I
would.
You like tequila.
Yes, I would.
Yeah.
Good stuff. And Sarah is responsible for me painting my entire kitchen very much. Follow her on Instagram. You'll get a lot of good ideas. And of course, follow Amanda Tatum as well.